What do you mean?
Are you feeling okay today? Because I don't want to embarrass you here. You know what
I'm feeling.
Because all the dough we're going to stay is from somebody here in this table. And
it got to me from somebody. It got to me from somebody.
So but like, the thing sometimes I feel like it become heavy. You know what
I'm saying? It become heavy. We like forcing it.
Yeah, what's up, YouTube, man? It's your boy, Usni. Welcome to the OBT show. Only big time, man. As you know, I'm always on my big time.
What do you do? Big time, man. Here's your boy, Larry. So before we start today's video, please hit the subscribe button, hit the like, you know, drop comment, share the video. If you guys noticed in the last video, we talk about how to find college soccer, how to find connection, how to get into a college soccer program, how to compete, you know. In today's video, we're going to talk about how to perform. Whenever you commit, whenever you find that college that fits you, how to perform against other, against your teammate, how to, you know, have a good influence in the team.
And then, like, it doesn't even have to be against. How to perform for the team.
How to perform for the team. Exactly. Course. So, Usa and I, we talk about it before the video. We talk about it for weeks now. And then we say, like, oh, we're going to drop some, you know, do's and don'ts. We're going to give you guys some, you know, some tips on how to do. And what do you think, Usa, is one of the don'ts? Let's start with the don'ts. Let's start with the don'ts.
Before we start the video, I feel like you're about to say some dumb stuff today. So I'm going to ask
you. What do you mean?
Are you feeling okay today? Because I don't want to embarrass you here. You know what I'm saying?
I'm feeling.
Because all the dumb we're going to stay is from somebody here in this table. And it's
it
not me.
It got to be from somebody. It got to be from somebody.
But it's not me. So,
but that's not from me for sure.
Alright. So like we start with the dumb.
Let's start with the dumb. Like what do you think is something like, you know, in order to perform in your college soccer team, you need to stay away from it. You need to avoid it. What do you think is a problem?
Something you need to avoid, like, you know, like, if you from high school, in your high school, actually, like, your senior year, you guys rap, like, you know, late night game, playing video game. If you're competing, you need to sleep, man. Sleep is important.
It's so important.
Sleep. So not getting enough sleep time, that's a no-no. You know what I'm saying? You can't. You can, that's a big no.
That's a big no, because you gotta, you know, guys, you gotta, big timers out there trying to compete, you gotta let your body heal, man. Your body.
Because you're going through a lot.
You're going through a lot. You're gonna go through a lot. The season is long.
And then, like, we're not even talking about just the game, but practice, the road, classes. Your brain get tired. You're gonna have to make sure you rest, bro.
And that's something y'all gotta, you know, gotta really like take, be accountable of your sleep schedule.
Your sleep schedule, like you said, like make a schedule and stick to it, man.
Yeah, stick to it. And transitioning to sleep, it also brings us one of the thing I think is a don't that you gotta stay away. Man, y'all gotta stay away from parties, man.
I'm telling you, man. We don't party at all.
So we make sure we don't party.
Make sure you stay away from party, man.
Stay away from party just as we don't.
I'm telling you. In the season, stay away from party, man. I mean, okay. What? One. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, listen. Right?
I'm gonna turn my best right now. No, one party might not kill you. No, actually party. Socialize. Make your break. Take a break.
You're gonna take a break from the soccer thing. But let's be honest though. No. Let's be honest here. Like, you know, you gotta stay away from parties, alcohols, drugs. You know, you want.
And like, even if you're drinking, that should be 21.
You gotta be 21.
If you're underage,
you
know, man. You know what I'm saying? Stay by the rules.
Stay by the rules. It's really important. You know, like, as we say, you know. It's not bad to party. It's not bad to socialize. Like, too much of partying.
Too much everything is bad.
Too much of everything is bad. And it can put you in a condition you really don't want to be. Some people, they're going to party their whole night until 6 or let's say 3 in the morning. And then they have practice at 6, 7. I think that's not serious.
And I feel like if you're a big timer, you didn't go to college to party. Of course, parties are part of college. You know, it's part of it. But you didn't go there to party. You know what I'm saying? Take your school and you're like...
That's actually crazy. We agree on that.
In sport,
and that's actually crazy. We agree on that because we were arguing about it.
Yeah, we are. But you know, sometimes like you get mature,
You get mature, right?
Yeah. That's 20 minutes. I just changed my mind. So,
bro. That's actually good.
So, what you got for us on the third spot?
No, I think there's a lot of players out there. You know, they gotta stop. You know, acting or pretend. They have to stop faking it, man.
Bro.
I'm tired of seeing it. I've seen it throughout my college career,
bro.
I've seen
but some guys, bro, the Denzel Washington on the field, bro. No cap. It's Brad Pitt. I'm telling you, bro. People be acting. Like, stop. Stop faking. When you fake, you think you're faking for the team. Okay, man, I fake the team, but you're faking yourself.
You're faking for you, man. You're faking for you. Lying for you, man. That you went to lifting, but you didn't go to lifting.
You can even go to lifting, but instead of doing 5 reps, you do 4. What's the difference between 4 and 1? Just cheating yourself. That little one thing, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, like,
people skip
by
reps.
Add up. Like,
they skip reps. They don't do the right reps. They don't follow the workout.
Like, when you're in the field. You know? When you're supposed to sprint, you jog. When you're supposed to jog, you walk. You're still sweating, but you're not working. You see what I'm saying? And when you do that, you don't improve.
You don't improve.
And over time, you come as your senior year, you can't even play. There is a freshman playing in front of you because you cheat for 3 years. And now you want to play, but it's too late.
You know, as you guys, we talk to you guys, we give you guys a lot of tips on how to compete, and it's really important to stay on top of your game, man. You gotta be taking yourself accountable, man.
Of course.
That's for the don't, I think.
So, like, all this done here, this is, like, of course, like, stuff happened in college, you know, politics, coach don't like you, you don't like the team, all that happened. But everything we say here right now, this is stuff that you as a player can control.
Exactly.
This is the controllable. This stuff you can control.
Yep.
You can control the weather. You can control, this is stuff you can control your
own. And you are accountable for it. You are accountable for all those, you know, downs and you know, moving. But,
so now though, I'm gonna go on my side.
Go ahead.
On what to do.
What to do.
What to do, Larry.
What to do, because it's really important. Like, guys, there's a lot of stuff you have to do in order to, you know, be on top of your game and to perform. And one of the things that I can't think of right now is, like, targeting your competition.
That's deep, man. Say that one more time.
Targeting your competition.
Bro, targeting your
competition. You gotta know, who you're competing.
Who you going for?
Who you going for?
I'm telling you, man.
There's spots. And you gotta know who you're fighting against. You gotta know who you gotta play in front for.
Like, of course, when we say targeting, that does not mean go break his neck in practice.
Nah.
Me and Larry can be friends. We all fighting for the same spot. That just means, like, sit on the paper, self-assessment. Yep. Mm-hmm. Okay, Larry, what is his strength? What is Larry's weakness? What can I do about his weakness? What can I do? Like, don't even focus on his strength because he's already good at those things. The step is not good at it, be good at those things.
Be good at those things.
So you can step in front.
Well, at the end of the day, and we talked about it earlier, and you were mentioning how the highest the level is, the less weakness people will have.
Of course.
So that's really important. Your strength had to. Your weakness has to follow your strength.
It has to be close. I don't think they will never be like equal.
Exactly.
But like the shortest the gap is between those two, the better player is going to be.
Exactly. And that's actually deep, man.
I never
thought about it until you say that.
I'm telling you.
The closer the gap is between your strength and your weakness will make you a big player.
Better player. That's how we see the pro. We like, these guys don't make mistakes. They do. Because, but like, the mistake.
You can't realize.
You can't realize.
Yeah, you can't realize.
Because the gap between his weakness and his strength.
It's too small. Yeah, but you know, talk about targeting your competition.
And your weakness.
Even, let's say you target your competition, right? You target your competitor, like, and you train hard, but you still don't get there. You still don't.
But do you know the quote that say, right? Don't work hard, work smart.
That's actually
same thing here. But us, we want you to train hard and smart. You see what I'm saying? Like, exactly. For example, like if you go to practice and you don't have a good touches, like you don't have good first touches, and all you do is sprint, it's good. But you gotta touch the ball a little bit. So be smart. You know what I'm saying?
Be smart about what you gotta adjust. What should you adjust? Is it your cardio or is it your first touch? So you gotta know what you should put more, you know, effort and focus on, which is that's actually.
And working on your weakness is not sexy. Because it makes you realize like that, like, okay, I need to improve.
I'm struggling.
So make sure, like, you know what I'm saying? When you work on your weakness, it's all mental.
It's all mental.
Make sure you actually put time on that thing. If you're practicing for like an hour, at least spend 25 to 30 minutes on your weaknesses.
Yeah.
So they can improve over time.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
And then talking about, you know, training smart, you know, fighting, you know, target your competition and, you know, and go against it. And go for it. I mean, what do you think is the last two that, you know?
You target your competition. Yeah. Now you're training smart.
Yeah.
Bro, use your resources. Like, go, like, the field, all the equipment that you got there, bro.
That's actually
the
true.
The field, the goal, your teammates. Like use everybody you can.
Exactly. Don't.
Of course, using people is not good. But using them in a good way, like, if Larry's a goalie, I'm a forward. bro, you want to practice more at 6 a.m.?
Yeah.
Yeah, we go. I'm practicing, but you practicing too.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? We're all practicing. Like, we can do one drill that's good for me, but we can do something that's good for you too. I can help you. We both win-win there.
That's true.
If you go to your coach, coach, okay, I want to do this, what I need, and the coach give you stuff that you need there, of course, you work him to improve yourself.
Yeah.
But if you get better, you're going to help the coach too.
That's true. And then nowadays, we got those old school, recovery session, recovery by training.
You can
farm roll, rest, recover your muscles, and go to ice bath, go to training room.
And talk to your teammate too, because
teammate.
Everybody around you have the same problem you have. You just don't talk about it.
Exactly.
Talk about it then, bro.
Yeah.
My hamstring's hurting me.
Yeah.
Oh, me too. I did, We help each other. Talk to your teammate,
you
bro.
You gotta be able to take a feedback too, because
you gotta
be strong and take feedback too, because you don't want to get
feedback.
Mad at
somebody. Yeah, of course. Feedback. Like, don't take anything personal.
We're just trying to, improve and help you. And then as Uz mentioned before, this is just about what you can control. Obviously, you're not going to control the team. You're not going to control the mood of your coach. You're not going to control the personality of your teammate. But this right here,
you can control
that as a player. And then
let us know in the comment what you guys think about this. And before we end up with the topic, what I got to say, when you come to college, you were the man in your high school. But once you move to college, Everybody was the man in high school. So you know what I'm saying?
So
make sure you humble yourself.
Humble yourself.
You think you're the man, you know what I'm saying? Like, until you hit the man. You see what I'm saying? Like, so humble yourself and make sure you can play at multiple positions. That's going to help you in college too.
You guys heard what he just said, man. Humble yourself. There's a lot of men out there. So you got to humble yourself in order to compete, But before we end today's video, please hit the subscribe button and hit the like. Comment, drop us note, drop in the comment. I'm sorry. Let us know what you guys think. What you think we should add as a do, as a don't. What do you think a college should do in order to perform in this team?
And like, if they have any question, you guys can let us know.
This is
the only big time, man. OBT, only big time. Let's get it.